In those days, the BBC had a strong regional presence, and in each region, our Radio 1 producer worked with the local light entertainment man. He would use his local knowledge to find suitable venues, groups, local DJs and stars to make personal appearances. Because of the union rules, we were unable to use our regular studio managers who had an expertise in balancing pop groups, so we couldn't create the best sound. Instead, we were required to use outside broadcast engineers who could be covering a football match on one day and Radio 1 Club the next. Some of them were very good and did their best. Others were, to put it bluntly, grumpy old buggers who hated pop music, and you were lucky if they managed to get the vocal mic opened when the lead singer started to sing. Ben Lyons was the local light entertainment man in Scotland, and he was a kindly man, though getting on in years, who did his best to get with it. The engineers, though, were always wont to have a laugh at Ben's expense, and Ben was always keen to add lots of echo to the singers and guitarists. He thought it made for a more commercial pop sound. He was frequently heard shouting at the engineers over the high volume speakers, "Give me more echo, please!" So one day they gave him control of one of the sound mixer knobs. They said they were making a big concession to union rules and would allow him to control the amount of echo by opening it as he wished. It was labelled Ben's Echo Fader. The band went on air and Ben was thrilled as they played their set. He kept winding his little fader up and down to get the result he required.